What is an apprenticeship? An apprenticeship is a training contract between you, your employer, and the apprenticeship office. How do I become an apprentice? To become an apprentice, you must be employed by an electrical contractor, and you'll be signed up into your training contract. How do I find an apprenticeship? Many employers will advertise for their apprentice intakes during the year, maybe at the start, middle, or end of the year. Other organisations like EGT, our group training organisation, they have rolling intakes, so you should always look out to apply whenever you're ready. How long is an apprenticeship? An apprenticeship contract lasts for 4 years. Do I get paid during my apprenticeship? The good news is yes, you get paid during your apprenticeship. In fact, being paid to learn is one of the wonderful things about doing a trade, and the electrical trade pays pretty well. Do I need to do a pre-apprenticeship to be an apprentice electrician? The short answer is no. However, many employers prefer that you have completed a pre-apprenticeship before they take you on as an apprentice. Who is CET? The College of Electrical Training is Australia's largest electrical training provider. We pride ourselves on training the best electricians, training over half of them in Western Australia. We aim to make you the best electrician we can by giving you access to the latest technologies, the latest training tools, and making sure that we stay up to date with all the things that are happening in the electrotechnology industry. How many days do I need to go to college? There's around 1,000 hours of training during your apprenticeship. Normally it lasts for 1 day a week for about the first 3 years of your apprenticeship, or 4 2-week blocks for that same 3 years of your apprenticeship. Is it hard to become an electrician? The electrical trade is a little bit harder than some of the other trades, mainly because we use a bit of maths and science, those things that you thought you'd never use at school. But we turn out many successful electricians, and you could be one of them. Do I really need to be good at maths to become an electrician? Yes, we do a lot of maths, especially in the theory subjects. Trigonometry, Pythagoras, algebra, transposition of formula. Yes, you thought you'd never have to do them again, but electricians use them when we're designing systems to make sure that they are safe and suitable for the application. What is a capstone assessment? The capstone is the final test of all the things that you have learned and practiced during your apprenticeship. We're going to test you on the things that you need to know so that you can become a safe and competent electrician. When can I sit my capstone? You can sit your capstone assessment 3 months before the end of your training contract. Do I need an electrical license to do electrical work? Yes. To do electrical work in Western Australia, you must have an unrestricted electrical worker's license. Do I need to have an electrical contractor's license to do electrical work? Yes. To do electrical work, you must be an electrical worker and hold an electrical contractor's license, or be an electrical worker working for someone who holds an electrical contractor's license. How much does an electrician earn? That's the $1 million question, but unfortunately not all of them earn $1 million. But electrical trades tend to pay a little bit higher than most other trades. In fact, they're consistently in the top 5 best paid trades in the industry. Is it safe to be an electrician? The electrical trade is a construction trade, and there is an element of danger in what we do, especially as we work with electricity. However, we train you to become a safe electrician, making sure that you take your life seriously, as well as those people that will be using the electrical systems that you install. What sort of tools does an electrician use? As an electrician, our main tools are pliers and screwdrivers, but we get to use a lot of other cool things as well. Multimeters, hammer drills, cordless drills, you name it. We use all of these things to make sure that we get the cables in correctly, that they're tested, and that everything is working before we hand it over to the homeowner. Should I be a domestic, commercial, or industrial electrician? Well, a lot of that will depend on who you're going to be doing your apprenticeship with. In the case of some domestic electricians, that's the only work they do, and you might find that you actually really enjoy working on people's houses. But if you like working on buildings or maybe even working on mines, then you'll have to choose commercial or industrial. Do I need a driver's license to become an electrician? While you don't necessarily need to have a driver's license, most employers are going to want you to have one because they're going to expect you to be able to drive the van or ute to go and maybe get morning tea or maybe go to the wholesaler and pick up some gear or even just drive them around. And if you have a manual driver's license, even better, because a lot of the work trucks these days are still manual. Will there be electricians in 10 years' time? Career opportunities in the electrical industry will continue to change as we see industry change. Technology is bringing about new innovations such as hydrogen, renewable energies, and other things like automation and electric vehicles. We expect there'll be work for electricians for decades to come. And when you look at some of the things that are coming across the horizon, being an electrical apprentice now will mean you'll have a career for decades.